What's up guys, Mizo Frizzo here, and in this tutorial I'm going to be showing you how to set up an aim state complete with reduced sensitivity and a tighter field of view. So as you can see here, I've got my hip fire sensitivity, and then when I press the right mouse button, sensitivity is lowered and I've got an animation that's playing and my field of view is tightened up. Now this is a very tight field of view indeed. It's just accentuated so that you can quite easily see it at work. This is super easy to set up. So without further ado, let me show you how to do this. Alrighty guys, now all I've done is create a new project using the first person template, and I have migrated a couple of animations that I made myself. It doesn't really matter what animations you use, but you will need an aiming animation. So this is basically, I just took the idle animation from the first person template and I raised the hands up and gave it a little bit of sway. It doesn't matter what animations you use, but you will need an animation to transition to. So with that in mind, let's open up the first person blueprint and first person blueprints and first person character, whatever your character blueprint is, open it up, and I'm going to create an input for my aiming, which I'm just going to use the right mouse button. You would obviously want to use an enhanced input for your project, but I'm not going to go through setting up an enhanced input on this tutorial. I'm just going to use the right mouse button, and on press of the right mouse button, we're going to set a Boolean. So we need to create a variable here and we'll just call it aiming question mark. And we're going to set it here off of pressed and released as true on pressed and false on release. So this is what's going to be used to tell our animation blueprint that we're aiming. And wherever else you might want to use that logic. So I'm going to head over to my animation blueprint. For me, I can just click the first person mesh here and find the anim class and browse to it. I'm going to open it up and head out to the event graph here. And I need a reference to my character. So I'm just going to use this one right here. I'm going to drag off the first person character and get aiming that we just created, and promote that to a variable, call it aiming, plug it into an execution pin, and now we have access to this aiming variable within our animation blueprint. I am then going to head over to the anim graph, and we'll see here that we've got this state machine, locomotion, rifle, state machine. So this is all our rifle animations. And I'm not going to go in depth about transitional rules and, you know, transitioning to and from different states depending on what your character's doing. I am just going to drag off of the idle state here and add a state, and I'll call it FPP underscore aim, like so. I'll also drag back into idle and I'll go into FPP aim, and I'm just going to drag and drop in my blend space that I've created. And this requires a ground speed, which is also not included in the first person template. So what we can do is just on this velocity node right here, if you want ground speed, if you want to add it to your first person template, you can do as follows. Drag off of velocity, get the vector length XY, promote that to a variable, call it ground speed, plug it into an execution pin, like so, and now we have access to our ground speed. Nice. I'm going to plug in ground speed here, and then I'm going to back out to that state machine, and I'm going to fill these transitional rules here. So to transition into aim, we are going to be aiming, so just plug in that boolean there, and to transition out we are going to be not aiming. Grab a not boolean so we're not aiming, we can transition back out, and that should work. If I pick up the rifle and I right click, it's transitioning into my aiming animation like so. It's a bit of a janky animation. I threw it together in like 5 minutes just to show you guys. Okay, so that is basically an aim state set up, but let's add a bit more functionality to this, such as slower walk speed while we're aiming and a tighter sensitivity and a tighter field of view. So we're going to head back into our first person character here, and let's do the walk speed first. So I can just grab my character movement here, just my character movement, and set max walk speed. Set max walk speed. There we go. And duplicate this one down here. Make sure to plug in the target. And let's just make this 300. It's quite a fast aiming speed, but that's how I set my blend space up. Nice. So that's the slower walking setup. Let's also do the sensitivity. So what we need for the sensitivity is the first person camera here. And actually, no, it's not. Sorry. It's a get player controller. Get player controller. And set deprecated input yaw scale. And also set deprecated input pitch scale. So this is basically the multiplier that's inside of these add controller yaw and add controller pitch inputs. So when this action value goes into this node, it's multiplied by, I think, 2.5. I think it changed in 5.2 or 5.3, but this allows us to set that. So we can also duplicate these and put it on released down here. And I'm just going to set these to some values that I found to be good. So for aiming, I'm going to put 0.4. And for the pitch, the vertical input, it has to be negated. So I'm going to put negative 0.3 in here. I'm going to make this one say 0.6. And negative 0.55. I'm going to make it slightly lower on the vertical because depending on the game, you know, traditionally in a first-person shooter, it's sort of more horizontal movement and you wouldn't want the vertical sort of movement to be as loose. So this, upon released, this input yaw scale and input pitch scale here is going to be our default. So we'll also want it to be that at event begin play. So I'm going to grab these nodes and I'm going to duplicate them up here. If you already have an event begin play node, you can just plug them into that. But I am just going to plug in that target, find event begin play, plug this in here. And now when we start, our input pitch and input yaw scale set to that. When we press the right mouse button and set to these ones and release, it's going to set back to default. So now I have my reduced sensitivity, much nicer than the crazy sensitivity that comes as default on the first person template. And now when I right click, it's much tighter. If you notice any, you know, like I'm right clicking now as I move and it's not aiming unless I stop moving, that's just because I didn't set it up to transition from this state, this walking state, into the aiming. So that's up to you to set up some more transitional rules and structure it how you like. I'm not going to go into that. Basically, the idea of this tutorial was just to set up the aim state, and I'm giving you this other stuff as a bonus. Let's do a reduced field of view. So for that, what we want to do is create a timeline. So we can right click and add timeline. I'm just going to leave it as named as timeline. This is going to play on pressed and reverse on release. I can double click this, open it up, add a float track here. And I'm going to make the length of the float track 0.2 of a second. I'm going to hold shift and click twice on here to add two key points. I'm going to select the first one and change the time to 0 and the value to 0. I'm going to select the second one and change the time to our maximum time of the length of this float track, so 0.2, and a value of 1. And that should be fine just like that. I don't really need to smooth it out. It's only going to play for 0.2 of a second. But the reason the value is 1 is because we're going to use this as the alpha on a lerp node. So we can back out to the event graph here and we can find a lerp node. Plug in the float track into alpha here, and this is going to lerp between our default field of view. So if you change the field of view, you'd want to just plug in your default here. Maybe I'll show you how to do that at the end real quick. But the default field of view, if you click on first person camera here and search for it's not field of view. Oh, it is field of view. Field of view 90. So the default here is 90. So I'm going to have it lerp from 90 to whatever you want this to be. I'm going to set this to 70, so it's just a bit accentuated. And then I'm going to get my first person camera here and set field of view on update of this timeline. And the return value of this lerp node will be my field of view there. Nice. So if I grab a weapon and I right click, I have that tighter field of view, lower sensitivity, lower walk speed, everything right there. Nice. That's pretty much it. But as I said, let's have a look at changing the field of view by default. So you could do it on event begin play. You could grab this and you could duplicate it up here. Whoops, did I lose those nodes? Duplicate it up here and on event begin play, set your field of view as a variable and we'll just call this default field of view. Whoops. So if you wanted your game to have a field of view setting in the options, you could set this in the options and then on event begin play, it will set it. I'll compile and I'll make this default field of view. Let's just make it something crazy like 70. And then here, you could just plug in your default field of view into that A on the lerp node, and let's make this 60 so it's just a little bit lower so we can see it at work. And you'll notice here that I can actually aim down the sights when I haven't picked up a rifle. So that's that field of view, that default field of view has changed. If I hit Alt P to play in editor, it's already got that much tighter field of view. But I can also aim down sights when I don't have the rifle. So what I might do is just in the first person template here, we've got a Boolean called has rifle. So I might just grab that Boolean, make a branch and only make this possible if we already have the rifle picked up like so. Nice. So if I hit play now, I can't zoom in or change the walk speed. As soon as I get the rifle, I can, like so. Nice. Guys, that's it. That's all we set out to do today. If this tutorial has been of any use or value to you whatsoever, please hit like and subscribe, and I will see you on the next one.